While former President Donald Trump was inside a New York courtroom for his criminal trial today, the Supreme Court heard arguments on whether or not he's immune from criminal prosecution for his efforts to overturn the 2020 presidential election. The arguments mainly centered around one question: what counts as an official act as president versus a private one?
If the president decides that his rival is a corrupt person, and he orders the military or orders someone to assassinate him, is that within his official acts that for which he can get immunity?
It would depend on the hypothetical, but we can see that could well be an official act.
Trump faces a federal trial on four felony counts, including conspiracy to defraud the U.S. and obstruction of an official proceeding for his alleged attempts to overturn the election. The Department of Justice argues granting absolute immunity to a president puts him above the law. And some justices appeared skeptical of the special counsel's charges, suggesting some conspiracy and fraud-related charges are too vague.
Would you not agree that that is a peculiarly open-ended statutory prohibition?
It's designed to protect the functions of the United States government, and it's difficult to think of a more critical function than the certification of who won the election.
Trump has pleaded not guilty to the charges. The Supreme Court is expected to release its decision before the end of June.